President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni has reiterated his call to add value to Ugandan and African coffee at large, saying if such a step is taken, the producers of the prestigious agricultural commodity will be able to get a fair share of the global market.
Some years ago, the global demand of coffee was 118 million bags, 60 kilograms. 118 million bags of 60 kilograms each. I hear that the global demand has now gone to 160 million or more.
The president made the remarks while officiating at the opening of the three-day second G25 Africa Coffee Summit held at Speak Resort Munyonyo, running under the theme, Transforming the African Coffee Sector Through Value Addition.
Affluence converts some of the tea drinkers into coffee drinkers. Therefore, I hear that Chinese who used to drink tea, because they have more money now, they drink coffee. That's why the demand is going up. And that's why I've been encouraging Ugandans to grow coffee. Otherwise, if it had no global demand, I wouldn't encourage them.
The summit attracted hundreds of stakeholders from top coffee-producing and exporting countries in Africa. Museveni explained that Uganda has managed to build an independent and self-sustaining economy with registered success in some sectors such as the dairy, fisheries, textiles, sugar, leather, among others. However, in many sectors, including that of coffee, the country is still losing a lot of money and jobs on account of exporting unprocessed raw materials abroad.
The one who roasts is a job. The one who grinds is a job. The one who packages is a job. All those jobs are exported.
President Museveni advised that as raw material producing countries, they need to conduct internal struggles in their respective countries to add value to these raw materials.
Now this is in one area of coffee. But if you take the whole spectrum of raw materials from agriculture, from minerals, from forest products, etc., the loss to Africa is massive.
The president of Ethiopia expressed concern that despite being one of the most traded commodities globally and consumed by people from all corners of the world, coffee didn't receive the proper attention it deserves compared to even some less traded commodities.
For it is important that we harmonize coffee standards under the African Continental Free Trade Agreement framework in collaboration with the African Standard Organization and the African Union Digital Platform.
Nós pensamos que com esta cimeira, os diferentes países africanos produtores de café devem unir-se mais.
I think with this summit, the African countries which are coffee producers, they should be much more united.
The Minister of Agriculture of Ethiopia and Chairman of the Inter-Africa Coffee Organization called for solidarity and commitment among the African coffee-producing countries to pursue their common goal to find solutions to the development of the sector on the continent.
We all must work to end this market unfairness together. With just simple value addition, it's possible to increase the benefit of smallholder farmers.
He, however, decried the huge inequality gap in the coffee value chain, saying that it could be explained by the fact that Africa obtains only 0.6% out of the total global value chain. At the same event, the African coffee-producing countries signed a Kampala Declaration. The Minister of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, Honorable Frank Tumwebaze, signed on behalf of Uganda, whereas other coffee-producing countries were presented by Dr. Gumar Amente, the chairman of the Inter-Africa Coffee Organization and Minister of Agriculture of Ethiopia.
To unlock the untapped potential of the coffee industry, capitalizing on the rising world prices and our expanding regional market of nearly 1.4 billion people.
The declaration will support, among others, research in coffee value addition to enable innovation and development of new products, generate new knowledge on best practices, improved technologies, and studies on varieties resilient to harsher climatic conditions, pests and diseases, investment in value addition of coffee and its products, and promote domestic coffee consumption, vocational training in coffee for the youth and women for job creation, and enhance access to finance for coffee value addition projects.